Hey guys, Mr. Bowman here. Today's learning objective is in pink, and we're learning about Pythagoras. Pythagoras is a name or a word we're going to become really familiar with over the next couple of weeks because we're going to be learning all about a theory called Pythagoras' theory. Before we move on to the theory itself and the mass and the numbers, I thought it would be cool. Let's get into a bit of history about Pythagoras because he's an interesting character, and there's a few stories or tales about kind of his life that have been lingering around since. So I've got a photo, it's Pythagoras, and you can see it's a painted photo of him because he is really, really old. He was born in 570 BC, and that was actually 2,591 years ago. So he's no longer with us, but he's left a few mathematical principles that are applicable to our everyday lives as his legacy. And I've got a bit in common with Pythagoras is that, like him, I really, really love numbers. I love numbers too. But the issue with Pythagoras, he probably loved them a bit too much. And I've got a photo here that I think demonstrates that. So this here looks like a really nice old painting, but it looks like they're in a church or a monastery. And this building is actually a bit of a religion or a cult founded by Pythagoras and his numbers. So he's started a religion or a cult all about numbers. And part of this religion was numerology, and that was the belief that numbers explained everything that was going on around everyone else. As an example, maybe it was raining too much one day and your crops died and you didn't have any food to eat. You know, Pythagoras, he would genuinely believe that, or there's too many sevens in your life. The sevens had this negative association that caused the rain. The rain killed your crops. So you need to get rid of these sevens from your life, and that'll make you better, which is outrageous. It's definitely not the case. But they really believed stuff like this. They also had the opposite view. They thought numbers were really, really good, really lucky. Like the number 10 was really lucky for them. And it was a bit of a god-like numbers on a bit of a pedestal. And they thought the number 10 bought good luck. So they really thought numbers around them explained absolutely everything that they see and do. Part of this cult, there was a gentleman called Hippasus. I've got a photo for you. There's his name, Hippasus. And he was one of his very loyal followers, and he took a bit of an oath of silence where they didn't speak about anything, and their job was to come up with an idea during this time. And he came up with this really cool idea. He discovered something called irrational numbers. And we know this to be true. We've dealt with some in our classes before, for example, pi, 3.14 and so on. That's an irrational number. We know it has everyday applications. He discovered these. But the issue for Hippasus is that conflicted with the teachings of numerology, because they thought every number could be expressed with regular numbers, like a fraction. But irrational numbers can't. And his discovery, you know, quickly spread, and it was inconsistent with kind of Pythagoras's beliefs and beliefs of his kind of religion or cult. And he was invited on a boat journey. What a wonderful treat. But the issue for Hippasus is Pythagoras was a bit of a goon, a bit of a thug, because his view on irrational numbers was inconsistent with Pythagoras's views. Hippasus found himself, this is all rumors and all stories, but he found himself thrown off the boat in the middle of the ocean, and unfortunately he drowned. So this was a quick video. Hopefully you found it interesting on the history of Pythagoras. He's a really interesting character. He lived some time ago. He started a bit of a cult, and he did act as a bit of a goon or a bit of a mobster for his day. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Now let's learn about Pythagoras and get into all the numbers.